right on the right side. And it's probably one of the most complicated buildings on Akita campus. Because it has three long sections, and going up one set of stairs won't get you to every room. So let's take a look inside. The first thing you see when you come into this building is this lovely mascot. This is the mascot of Akita University, and his name is Kamon-kun, because he is a small little antelope. And he's adorable. Unlike, you know, American universities where we have to have the mean and aggressive ones. No, we choose cute and adorable mascots. This is the map of the building. And as you can see, we have this strange U shape. And then this strange W. And it's really complicated because the middle classrooms on the upper floors block you from getting to other ends of the classes. So the best way to find classes is to use the side stairs and not the middle stairs. They get very confused. But if you take classes here, if you come to study here, you may only have one or two classes here. I only had one in my second semester. Otherwise, they're in other buildings. But it's a very important building anyways, because on this first floor is someone who works here who is very important. Let's go meet her. So we're going to meet a very important person who's in charge of all kinds of documents and signatures and things like that. Her name is Taniguchi-san, and she's a wonderful lady. You need to come to this room. It is on the first floor of the Education 1 building. So, let's go meet her.
こんにちは。元気ですか?元気です。はい。ここはいつでも来てもいいところですよ。はい。今日ここで何のことをするのか、留学生のこと。留学生の、何か困ってることだとかを、いつでも相談しに行ってくれていいところですよ。はい。ステファニーさんがちょっと勉強の教室がわからないだとか、
こういうお手紙来たけどどうしたらいいですかというのを質問を受けるところです。よく聞きますね。はい、ありがとう。はい、これが谷口さんです。はい、谷口です。セントクラウドの皆さん、ぜひ秋田大学に来てください。Hello
everybody, I'm 70 Gillis. I'm a one-year international exchange student here at Akita University. And before coming here, I really didn't know anything about Akita University except for the fact that it was built in 1949. And that was all I could find out on the internet. So, I've decided to make you a small documentary about Akita Daigaku. So some interesting facts about Akita University is that compared to American universities, it has much less students. Akita University only has 951 students attending right now, as compared to St. Cloud State University, which has, you know, about 20,000. So, it's a very small university, but it's really close, and everybody really knows each other, and it's a good environment. Along with it being a very small university, there's only three faculties. There is the Faculty of Education, Medicine, and Engineering and Resource. And the whole school is split up into those three categories, but most international students tend to be in the education, or kyoikubu. And lately, the president of the university has changed and is now Yoshimura Noboru. Remember him, he's very important. Right now, we're at the main gate of Akita University, and from here, we'll enter and show you around campus.
Because of things that I studied music. So I'm used to practice in the teacher's offices,
something you will need to be able to practice. It's not required, but it's recommended that you have one of these cards to practice. And you can get them from a teacher who's upstairs, and it's really easy to do. Let's take a look inside the room. They're really small, and
the piano's very standard. It's the same piano you'd see in America. Nothing really different here. But they're very small, they're not soundproof, and sometimes the lights don't work, but it's just a good small area if you want to practice piano or singing or any other instrument you may play.
So this isn't actually on the campus, but it's right outside the campus. So if you look right now, behind you is one of the entrances. This over there is the music building, and over here is Education 3. And then on this side, just outside campus, is a restaurant called Restaurant Emu. And it is my favorite restaurant here. It's really good because it's so close. So in case you don't want to eat at the cafeteria, you can come here. And they have delicious food, and the lady who works here is so nice to international students, and they even have a menu in English. And my recommendation would be the hambagu. Not hamburger, it's hambagu, which is kind of like a small meatloaf patty with fantastic sauce on it. And there's also a chicken teriyaki and tonkatsu, which is to die for. So if you ever want to not eat on campus, come to this place, although it is not open on Sundays, unfortunately. But otherwise, it's a great place. It's open from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. on weekdays.